Here we go. Men's division ends Friday. Who is my bonus guy here? We have any one of the Usos, Hall of Fame, Yoko. Which, let's take this step by step here. So you have Jimmy, which I haven't worked on, so we're going to move on from that. We have Jay that I have at 4-star gold. This one's going to be the one that many people actually have. So, first things first, let's take a look at him. And let's make him. I have shards for days for him. So let's go ahead and make him 5-star gold. I mean, 5-star bronze, excuse me. That's not one I'm going to move up much further than this. But that extra health is going to be beneficial. Yeah, that's going to take me down way too much on coins. So let's go on and burn up some of these Jey Uso shards, right? Okay, super kick, reduce tag counter. Okay, so that's a tag match move. Okay. Destroy 4 purple gems. See, this is one of those things you have to think about here. 3-turn countdown gems that destroy sub. Oh, okay. That could be useful. Okay. And then we have this that decreases countdown gems by 1. Well, it might be more than that by the time I'm done bringing it to level 14. This could be fairly playable. Now let's go on and move him up, and I guess I'll use this guy to start a video series. I'm gonna have to edit this here stream and. Start a Forgotten Characters video series. All right. Let's make it happen. So this is going to be. All right. So, what's up, people? Here we go. We're going to start a video series with just this portion of this live stream. So bear with me, because I'm going to edit this out and put my video editing skills to the test. So here we got Tech, Jey Uso, the Uso is one of the earlier cards in the game that most people really don't mess with anymore. I just recently moved him to 5-star bronze. Why? Because he's a bonus superstar in one of the monthly tours. All right, so let's take a look at him, right? So, of course, he's a tech, right? His link, you got SmackDown, you got the Fatu family, you got Usos, you got an OI, My Vey, a Legacy, you got Modern Era. He has no gear, right? So, pretty much cut and dry, your basic of basic cards, right? He's a coach that reduces opponent sub moves at this level by 3, which that can be great because, hey, you get thrown into a sub and it only takes one turn. That's not going to do much damage. So that could be usable. All right. So his moves, we got the Samoan Splash. That's a finisher. 39,000 damage, and you get 4,000 bonus damage for every countdown gem. You got Northern Lights. That you make 4 countdown gems with that. After 3 turns, destroys a random 2x2 area. You got your super kick, which is a tag team move. You don't see these often anymore. When in a tag match, It's going to reduce your tag counter by two turns. You gain three purple MP, but this move is pretty much useless outside of a tag match. You got your Samoan drop. Destroys four purple gems and does 22,000 damage. Running hip attack, again, 22,000 damage. And you choose four to destroy. You got your Dragon Whip that does... I'm interested in this one. Your Dragon Whip does five random gems in the countdown gems that deal zero damage when activated, but break for sub gems when activated. So you find yourself in a bind. This would be the one to have all over the place, but you also want to think about your finisher, right? You have Northern Lights. We can get rid of Super Kick from the from there. Okay, we also have the Fallen Power Bomb. 22,000 damage decreases your countdown timers by two. All right, so let's get over to the moves, what we're going to use, right? So let's go on and add Dragon Whip into the play. That's a one charge move that throws five countdown gems on the board. So every turn, we're throwing five countdown gems that are going to last three turns. All right. His green move does a 4,000 bonus for each countdown gem. All right. So let's find what's going to work with this guy. So we don't have to worry about yellow move. And to me, move charge isn't going to make us a whole lot of difference here. So let's go to all. We're going to do, what we're going to be looking for is move damage, specifically green move and purple move damage. Because, okay, your Dragon Whip doesn't do much of crap, right? So let's go to move damage here. We're going to do move damage or... Let's see, we want green or purple. Okay, so that could come into play. Put Lesnar here. That gives us a boost. Gives us a boost to green, and we take less damage from purple. All right. Let's go on and throw Godfather in here. Actually, you know what? Let's do this. Let's take him off of Blaze. And let's roll. Okay, so that's pretty much going to be that. Let's see, what if, do we have one that gives a chance of more green gems at start? That would be good. I mean, all else fails, I can throw Santa Hogan on here to make his gems hit harder, which, for a 5 bronze, this is terrible, considering what's normal these days. So, Santa Hogan might be the way to go here. Green moves a deal damage, 25%. Blue gems, red gems. Let's see here. Black gems. We don't have one for green? Yeah, I'm thinking we're gonna throw a Santa Hogan on him. That's what I think. I think we're gonna throw Santa Hogan on him. Make his gems hit a little harder. Give that little kick in the ass that we need there. All right. So that's what we got. We're gonna run Lesnar to do 30% more green damage and take 45% less from purple. We're gonna do Godfather, which gives us another 30% to green moves. I don't have any black moves, so the rest of that's pointless. We're gonna use Vecina or Texina, whichever one you'd like to call him, and that's gonna be 15% more green move damage and generate one more countdown gem. And Santa Hogan, where he comes in clutch, is he adds 2200 to each gem for gem damage. All right, so that's how we're gonna run him starting out. We're gonna go with Samoan Splash, Northern Light Suplex, and Dragon Whip for starters. So let's check this out. This is one I haven't played with much. So let's see what we got here. So off top, we got. Okay, so apparently he has the MLC boost. He's gonna throw 9 countdown gems. And keep in mind, I'm going to be losing out on 4 countdown gems after this MLC. So those 9 are not, it's not always going to be 9. But we throw down 9 again. We throw down 8 more. See, that right there can be critical. We're going to make an adjustment after this. Now, keep in mind, I'm not even running a strap on him right now, so. This is going to be, a test run of sorts. And you also have to keep in mind, my way is not the way. It is a way to run this guy. There's going to be multiple ways to do it. So you look at this, right? You have several countdown gems. You throw down more. Right? Then you do this. You're doing 62,000 damage plus another 4,000 for every countdown gem. So that can add up quickly. But of course, you're not going to see what kind of damage it is because he's already in danger. So let's move on. I mean, that moveset's viable, but it's kind of hard to see what it really does with such a weak opponent. Let's move on to hell mode real quick. We're gonna completely skip over hard mode because well, my level VIP. Nah, let's go ahead and run it. It shouldn't take me that long. Let's go ahead and put him in and let's go tag links. We got the Usos matching purple charges more purple. We got the Maivia Legacy. Gems do 25% more damage. That's probably gonna be the way to go. You got WrestleMania that doesn't do shit. God bless it. You got SmackDown, Add to Move, Charge, Modern Era, 5%, Gem Damage, and No Links are at the bottom. So let's go with this is the way to go right here. Get that bonus gem damage, which again is not going to play much of a factor on hard mode. But what I want to do is get through this mode so we can actually look at what kind of damage he's doing against some 5-star opponents. All right, so we got the purple move charged. See, that right there is what I'm interested in. I'm interested in that purple move more than the yellow. So we're probably going to make some drastic changes to the way this is being done. Because while the Dragon Whip's countdown gems are nice whenever you're using the Samoan Splash and you have 20 plus countdown gems on the board, you know, it doesn't do you many favors. When there's no sub in play. Alright, so we're getting closer to his talent level, so it should be a little more interesting here. All right, now it's my turn. It's my turn. All right, so let's go on and throw down some more countdown gems. You know, we're still at over 100,000 health with our opponent, so let's go. At 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. That's 23 countdown gems. At 4,000 a pop, you're looking at 4,000 a nice chunk there. Looking at about 80,000 damage there. Alright, so I'm actually going to switch from the... Let's switch up a couple of moves real quick. So this ought to be a little... I don't want to replace him. I want to adjust his moves. Okay, so we're going to take out... and take out Dragon Whip. And we're going to add Samoan Drop. Now, having a couple of green moves with the way I have him built makes more sense. But these moves do less damage, but will do more frequently, if I'm not mistaken. 6 and 6 as opposed to 10. Yeah. The way I have it set, it should be interesting to say the least. Do I have a title I can put on him? No. Yes. But do I want to take that off of Edge right now? This one. Okay, yeah, that's a Rainmaker. That stays on him. Some move defense boost. It's a health boost. Takes 8,000 to move it. Okay, which I don't have. Alright, that's fine. I'm good with that. Actually have several I could put on him. A bunch on characters that I don't even use. Yeah, I need 8K to move it regardless. Alright, so yeah, we're just going to run him without a strap. So here's my thought process here. We're going to get the countdown gems on the board. The one time I take it off, huh? All right. One time I take that move off, we're facing somebody with a submission. All right, that was a good amount of damage there. I'm finally going to get my countdown gems on the board. Okay, so this move set against somebody with a sub is not optimal. All right. In this situation, you would have wanted the yellow one. That's about my luck. I'm taking off, and I take that move off, and I'm fighting somebody with a sub. Utilizing Jay is going to be situational, but I think he can be actually used later on in the game. I might actually I should have known. All right. I'm gonna use him anyway. At least in this match, I'm going to use him. Then we're going to move on to one of the bonus characters for Hell Mode because, of course, the character that most people are going to have is not going to be a bonus character in Hell Mode. So, we got all moves charged. Every single one of them. Let's do this first. Make sure I don't put it on top of any purple gem. Right? Then we turn around and break purple gems. We decrease countdown by 2. Break the green, and we're ready to go again next round. Let's see how this goes. He's usable probably more so once he's leveled up. Alright, so now do that. is do this. Then we'll do this. You see now, Greg's finisher is coming. That breaks, and we're out. That gives us that. We do this here, and this should be just about over. No purple breaks, no green breaks. All right. And then these four are still on the board, breaking everything, and this match is over. So, I mean, somewhat usable. Maybe more if he's leveled up to 5 silver, 5 gold. Maybe. But at that level, he can easily run through things. Now, take a look at him once more. Let's manage. Okay, so that's going to be useless. I can choose 4 gems to destroy. See what we're looking at. Okay. We're destroying 4 purples. We're choosing 4 to destroy. Which would bring... Okay. So, the last one I'm going to look at is purple, purple, green. Okay. Which is going to make us change up some things here. The coaches will stay, the trainers will change. Why will the trainers change? Because, once again, you're looking at destruction here. So let's move destroy. Put Jimmy in play. Let's remove him. And let's put... Who are we going to put in play? Who's that destroy gems? Green loser destroy gem, destroy 5 more gems. Got 2 of them like that. Loser destroy heal gem, cello move, loser destroy. No one's in there. Multiplies, okay. So let's do Moves that destroy silence gems. Don't press. No, we don't want him. We want this guy. Let's pull him. I'll have him on Santa Hogan of all people. Okay. Now. Let's make some magic, fellas. One last look at him. And then we're going to move on. And I'll have some video editing to do and put this one up here. Alright, so we're going purple, purple, green now. Oh, that's beautiful. So we're going to charge up the purples out the gate. We're going to throw down this here. I have a feeling this is going to be my favorite moveset. Choose 7 gems to destroy. Alright, and then we're destroying random purple gems. Probably should have waited on that because of what he does. But that's okay. All right, and here that goes, and boom. 78,000. All right, that's not bad. It's not terrible at all. I still have a feeling this is going to be my favorite moveset out of the 3 that we've looked at. And I'm sure there's many other ways you can run this guy. Let's drop purple. Not purple. Countdowns. Drop some countdowns. I'm going to put them all at the bottom. And we choose 7 to destroy. We drop. Oh, that was accidental. Damn it. Damn itchy trigger finger. All right, let's try this again. Purple. Which drops the countdown gems. Destroy 7 gems. 2, 4. Only have 6 of those. But I have 2, 4, 6. I have 7 green gems. So let's charge up the green. Now we have 2, 4, 6. We have 7 purple on the board. So let's destroy them. I like this moveset. Could you run different trainers? Oh, hell yeah. You could have him destroying less and charging up moves or whatever the case may be, but I like this. Combine this with a Fury strap. A strap with 4 Fury metals on it, and you got yourself a fairly solid guy.